Hi, everyone, and welcome to this week's Crush It in Sales podcast. And I am so grateful that you joined me today. Thank you so much. I took this picture of a hot pink flying pig months ago as this statue, this garden statue, is in the yard of my aerial yoga instructor's house, Glenda. I took the picture because I love hot pink. And it reminded me of when I was a sales rep and I had a home and garden line called Napa. It was a very, very popular line. It probably still is right now. And I sold a lot of flying pig statues. Oh my gosh, I sold a lot. White flower pots, white orchids, and flying pig statues. I could pretty much put on anyone's order. And what used to strike me as so interesting and somewhat odd is that the saying, when pigs fly, is actually not a great saying. And I Googled it, and I'm going to read to you what it says on Google. It's used to say that one thinks that something will never happen. Have you ever thought about that? If you see that statue, do you actually realize what it says? So it's kind of interesting that people buy this statue and put it in their yards, right? It's actually a limiting belief. And that's what I wanted to talk to you about today and share with you is just how many of us still go around with limiting beliefs in our subconscious and that also pop out of our mouths, things we say. I hear it so often that it's really very amazing to me. It's something that I know I've had to work on, which is why I think I'm more in tune when I hear other people say a limiting belief. It could be anything from using the word try or just not having the confidence to do something. And quite often, I even hear it from fellow coaches. I'll be having a conversation with someone and I'll be like, oh, Biz, what are you saying? And people are like, oh my gosh, you're right. It's very, very, very fascinating. So I really wanted to make the topic of this podcast, limiting beliefs, and just building awareness around what you are saying, what is coming out of your mouth, and likely what's going on in your brain. Because sometimes even we don't end up saying it out loud, right? It's going on in our brain still. So really building some awareness as you go through your day. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I just said that. Oh my gosh, that was a limiting belief. What is causing that? And starting to do a deep dive to nip those limiting beliefs in the bud. And we all have them. Again, we all have them. But you just can work on getting stronger, eliminating them faster, and then not having them at all. We all have the power within us to retrain our brains and not go through this process. We all have this power and capability. So an article that I wrote last week on Medium shares 10 positive affirmations. I really find that the majority of people love hearing positive affirmations. If you're one of those people, you might be nodding your head as you listen to this podcast. But often we need a little help in thinking of them, maybe committing some to memory, and then actually using them as a tool. So it's not like you just read it and move on with your day and you're not actually embodying that shift. You have to embody the shift. And further on that, you actually have to feel that shift in your body. That's why we say them. That's why we say them. It's not just for decoration on a pillow. It's to actually use them to shift your mindset and feel better so positive things start to happen for you. And I wanted this to be on the Crush It in Sales podcast because I feel it's really important for business people, entrepreneurs, fellow coaches, anyone in this space that is a business person, which is likely almost everyone listening to this podcast, to have the awareness and start to really embody positive affirmations if you're not doing that. Because again, I feel a lot of people really don't do the work. So I'm going to, again, link this article in the show notes that I wrote last week. And I'm also right now going to read you five of them. And what's really important to note is, you know, take these down, write them down, pull up the article, write them down, but feel free to shift them for what works for you. And if you can shift them to where you have them memorized and you don't have to look at a piece of paper or a sticky note, and they're just like easy for you to pull and say, then that's even better. Like, I don't care what you do with these, like in terms of shifting them for yourself, go for it, go for it. And that's how you should look at pretty much anyone's content. It's like, how can I apply this for me to transform and make a difference? You don't have to take everything that everyone says word for word. Use it for your own benefit, for how you feel and what you need to accomplish and shift and change in your life. So here we go. And I'm just going to read the first five. Again, the link will be in the show notes for this article where there are more. And then there's another article that I wrote maybe like a month ago with some more positive affirmations. And I will put that link in the show notes as well. So you have a plethora to choose from. Maybe pick like two or three that really call to you, or two or three that you feel like shifting. Write them again, write them on a sticky note, a piece of paper, commit them to memory, and really get them ingrained and embodied in your life. And they really help because, you know what, if you're having a bad thought or you're triggered or, you know, something's just not going right in your day, pull this out of your pocket. That's what you can use them for, is pull them out of your pocket to shift your mindset. So here we go. Number one, I am letting go of old habits to bring in opportunities. Number two, every day I embrace new ideas and opportunities. Number three, I can make it through the day. It will all work out. Number four, I choose to trust and know it will all work out. And number five, I let go of other people's judgment and opinions. And I would love to hear from you if you have some that you would love to add to the two lists that I'll be linking in the show notes, because I'm more than happy to create another article and give you credit. I would love that. I'm always looking for new affirmations myself. I use them all the time. And they have just been really life-changing and transformational. It's a tool as old as the hills. One could even say there's affirmations in the Bible, right? You can pretty much pull affirmations and quotes from any really, really established leader, and you'll see that this isn't something new. So I really hope that in that people realize it works, and to use it to shift and transform and create more success in your life, in your business. So until next week, thank you so much for listening. Feel free to connect with me, my private one-on-one coaching, my email, and all things will be in the show notes. And until next week, I hope you crush it in sales. Thanks again.